Hey everybody, welcome back to The Witcher 3 Hearts of Stone. We need to read Shani's character entry in the journal to find out what might cheer her up. I think we let her down a little bit, honestly. She did say, like, she had different expectations. I don't say different, I say higher. Like, I think she was looking for this to be more of, like, a date. But then, like, Vladimir got involved, and there are feelings back and forth, but let's see where things go, shall we? Let's look for Shani. Let's see. Okay, Geralt entered the Oxford sewers expecting to hunt down a hideous monster, so you can imagine his surprise when down one of those dank, slimy corridors he ran into Shani, an old and dear friend. Geralt and I had first met this extraordinary young woman years earlier when she was just a cultish co-ed, but by this time she had grown into a dignified doctor and a fearless field medic for the Redanian army. This latter role had led her and a unit of soldier escorts to descend into the sewers. Their goal was to gather a sample of the venom spewed by the monstrosity squatting there. Geralt, a gentleman, though through and through, agreed to help her in her task. Geralt's encounter with Vladimir von Evrich reminded him that he and Shani had once shared passionate, though passing, feelings for each other. He also became aware some remnant of these feelings, was still lodged in his heart. At times, fate composes tales so shocking no poet would dare put his name to them for fear his public would mock them as overly outlandish. Such was the case when Geralt and the ghost of Vladimir von Evrich shared a body for an evening and accompanied Shani to the wedding of Aldona, her friend from the academy. Some might have let this unusual escort interfere with their enjoyment of the evening, but not Shani. Looking around at the tasteful wedding decorations, smelling the rich odor of berry-laden rowan, a plant near and dear to her heart, one which summoned up fond childhood memories, Shani felt the heedless abandon of her younger years return and, overjoyed, threw herself into the thick of the festivities. One thing is certain, Shani was not bored by the company of Vladimir von Evrich, who showered her with professions of burning desire and swept her off her feet with his maniacal energy. Yet when the hour came for him to return to the netherworld, she breathed a sigh of relief, for now she could spend some time alone with Geralt, who was much more sensitive and predictable, though Vlad would probably just call him boring. Which is true. But she's into rowan, berry-laden rowan, which is a plant, that brings up childhood memories. So, let's look for it. It's not gonna be this.
Good mead ought to lift her spirits.
No!
Sip of something strong never hurt anyone. Question is, will it cheer her up?
I don't think so. Let's leave it.
Good idea? Maybe not. She might be a sad drunk.
I think so. Let's look around here. Anything?
Rowanberry brandy.
Oh, okay. Rowanberry brandy.
Enjoy this as well. A sip of something strong never hurt anyone. Question is, will it cheer her up?
I think it probably will, but let's leave it for now and check out what the other one is.
Not. She might be a sad drunk.
What the hell?
A rowan.
Yes.
Shani mentioned she used to weave the berries into necklaces. Pretty, I guess. Thing is, will it cheer her up?
I think so.
Fine, I'll pick some. Becoming quite the romantic.
I actually really think that she's gonna be, like, swooning. Oh, she's not having a great time.
Still here? Thought you had to meet Olgierd.
You and I see each other so rarely. Figured old Geert could wait till morning. Smile, Shani.
You remembered I liked the rowan.
Remember a lot of things about you. Wedding's still in full swing, but your face, I'd say you were at a funeral. Why so sad?
Sad? Not really. It's just... after I caught the garland, I realized something.
She doesn't have anybody.
Years are flying by, yet all I ever do is study, pump stomachs, and reattach limbs. All alone.
Yep.
You got me.
For how long? A day? Two? Don't get me wrong. It's nice, but you come and go. Yet I need someone who'll be there every night when I come home. After a day of bandaging wounds and sewing up guts, I need a good glass and a good laugh with someone who'll help me forget it all for a moment.
I get it. And yeah, could never be there for you every day. But I am happy to see you always. And today, I'm all yours.
Well, in that case, let's drink to tonight.
To tonight. Uh-oh. May the moment last.
I'm afraid the drink's gotten to our minstrels. Horribly off.
Let's go for a walk.
Good idea.
Doesn't sound that bad to me.
Did you enjoy the wedding?
Not half bad. Might have even enjoyed myself if I hadn't had to argue with a madman's ghost, be his puppet. Gotta admit, though, thanks to him, I did experience a lot of things I might have missed otherwise.
Got that right.
Chasing a dog through the woods, or brawling, fence board in hand?
Forgetting something. There was also a kiss.
True. Though that was so clearly Vladimir. I nearly forgot you were involved at all.
Uh-oh.
His will, sure, but my body felt everything. Reminded me of the old times.
Vizima, you mean? Oh, I thought you'd forgotten our whole Catriona story.
One does not simply forget that.
Sure, but the romantic bits in that adventure? Don't plan to forget those.
You needn't worry about our finances, sir. My workshop, business is booming.
Good. I'm relieved to hear it. See, coin's tied to Torrent. But don't tell the old battle-axe. She'd be furious if she learned to let it slip.
Never you worry, sir. My lips are sealed as the grave.
Uh-huh.
Some folk need to stick together.
Sir. Enough of that. I'm Vassy. But you can call me Dar.
Oh, thank you, Dar. I feel honored. Let's drink on it.
Seems the families are bonding.
A bride's father and his son-in-law? Stiff at first, but add drink and they bond or slap each other silly.
I was afraid the wedding wouldn't happen at all.
Mean the differences in wealth?
Mm-hmm. Jonas's family didn't consider Aldona worthy.
Clear they love each other, though. Parents usually give in if that's the case.
Usually, not always.
Oh, I don't know. My mother would never accept an unfit beau.
No
Even
shit!
If I insisted I loved him, had chosen him.
I remember her. I think it... or was it your grandmother? It doesn't matter. She was terrible.
Doubt your mother's that unbending? You'd win her over, I'm sure.
I haven't managed to yet.
You only ever bring home fiddlers, jugglers, and witchers?
No, but she'd want me to choose someone wealthy, or with a good trade, well brought up.
Nothing wrong with that, is there?
I guess not, but it's hard to find one like that who's still even slightly amusing.
That's probably true.
Tell that to my mother. She actually thinks I should have found a husband at the academy. But I didn't. Ugh. I'm certain she thinks there's something horribly wrong with me.
Oh, please, Shani. It's the 13th century. Women don't go to the academy to find a husband. They go to learn, pursue their passion. You did that. I'm sure your mother appreciates it.
Yeah, but it wouldn't have hurt to bring back a husband, I think.
Been at the front lines many times. You're a good person. Not a thing wrong with you.
Really think so?
Really. Look, the brave brothers.
Drank themselves stiff as the boards they tore from the fence.
Wonder where the sister is. Couldn't protect her from a cheeky four-year-old in that condition.
If they hadn't intervened, you'd have gone for a tumble in the hay with her. She was willing, if you ask me.
I wasn't in the mood. Would have resisted, tried to regain control.
I think you would have seized the opportunity.
I don't need opportunities like that.
Changed your style.
Let's say I've grown choosy.
You say that as if you've already picked.
Because I have. Guess who?
Uh-oh.
Ooh. Gorgeous.
Been thinking about that kiss.
What kiss?
The one Vladimir planted on your lips, with my lips. Just wondering if it would have felt any different without him there.
That I cannot tell you.
Only one way to find out.
Only one way to find out.
So, how'd it compare?
Definitely rather kiss you alone, of my own free will. Correct me if I'm wrong, but I do believe Vladimir was after more than a kiss. Said so openly, in fact.
All true. He was very direct, I'll give him that.
It's hard to not
Which
hear Vladimir still
has
a bit.
Its advantages.
You're right. Can save a lot of time.
So, how do you stand today, Geralt? Have some time to waste with me? Or would you rather go back now?
Are you kidding me?
Promised you this night. Aim to keep my word. And I aim to be direct. Even more so than Vladimir.
Sounds interesting.
Interesting is what interesting does.
Oh, there's the sister.
Here's taken.
Got a feeling it's about to free up.
How did you know?
I'm clairvoyant.
Among other things, yep, sure.
Practically full.
Be ashamed to let it go to waste.
Besides, we leave it here, a very drunk person could find it, drink themselves into even more trouble. And I swore a solemn oath. First of all, do no harm.
Are you going out on the boat? Okay, good call.
Row me to the moon.
Gotta fly to get to the moon.
Just a saying.
You're dead wrong. Look. It's right there, in the middle of the lake. What are you doing?
What one usually does on the moon.
Oh, did I say that you should have covered your eyes for that? Because you should have.
Awake already?
For a while now. Did you know you've gained 27 new scars since we last saw each other?
She would be keeping track.
Mm-hmm. I do that sometimes.
Did
27 new scars.
To the moon?
Forgotten already?
No. Not the sort of thing you forget.
Exactly.
Sound like you wish you could.
No.
Uh-oh.
I certainly won't forget that. And I definitely don't regret it. But I do need to sort it all out in my head.
Yeah, complicated.
Shani, wait. Before you go, need to ask you a favor.
Yes?
It's about Olgierd. Seems a mysterious man. Can't escape the impression his story's more complicated than I thought. Could you look into it? See if you can learn something?
Sure. Be glad to.
Thanks. Be seeing you.
Yes. See you later, Geralt.
Morning after. And the walk of shame. That's what's happening right now. Well, after a night like that, I don't think we are going to jump anywhere. We're gonna enjoy our time. No regrets about the time with Shani. I think that was really, cool, actually. And what Yennefer doesn't know can't hurt her, right? That's a bad attitude, I'm well aware, but pretty sure tables were turned. It would be fine. We have a bit of an understanding. Von Everick Estate. Hold on. Is this, yeah, Von Everick Estate.
It's getting cold.
Is there anything going on in here? The history of the Von Everick Estate is as tangled as that of the family itself. The once wealthy Redanian family's manor and lands were auctioned off after they fell deeply in debt, but were returned to Von Everick hands by Olgierd, the infamous leader of an informal band of armed men calling themselves the Redanian Free Company. Despite the effort he went through to regain it, Olgierd abandoned the residence sometime later, and dark legends concerning it now circulate among its neighbors. Ooh. Okay. There's not much happening here now, but perhaps later. And since we have to go see Olgierd in, he's in Oxenford, if I'm not mistaken. Yes. Let's get some stuff done along the way.
Let's go!
Why not? Oh, maybe... Oh, hold on, let's see. Oh, I see, yeah, okay. I was like, that little shack, this whole thing is the estate, which we've been to before, but for some reason, it was letting us know that we got there. The little shack, no. Okay.
Come on, Roach.
Cleared that up. In a way, I do feel a bit bad for Shani, like... I know she's cool, but she clearly wants to, like, settle down, and she knows that that would just not happen with us. But, you know, it's like... She's probably just putting a lot of her and her mother, I guess, but probably putting pressure on herself to, like, find somebody and settle down. And I think when people do that, they make really poor life decisions. Like, when you're just trying so hard to find somebody. What do we got going on here? Oh, we got more knights. Wouldn't you believe it?
Witness me, brother!
Whoa! Okay, can we not get some different potions going on here, please? And did we just I think we just triggered Cat. So, let's clear that out. I I see the archer.
Spells! Spells!
I live again!
Whoa! God, you guys hit hard.
Faster for fuck's sake!
Witness me, brothers!
How do you wish to die?
Wow. That was just poor on my part. Let's give that another shot.
Sing, brothers!
Sing! Sing! Sing!
Faster for fuck's sake!
Oh! Let's throw on this stuff. That'll help. Okay, let's go for these guys. Come on! Okay, let's switch out our potions as well.
Witness me, brothers! Oh, what a day! What a lovely day!
Back, holy moly. Back! I see what you're doing over there.
You shall die! Die!
There's one.
That's enough of that.
Jeez. Oh, we're also missing the beautiful Echidna.
Come on, come
back,
closer.
Back. These guys, they just take forever to deal with. There we go. There we go.
That's enough of that.
You guys got strong. Master Topical.
I thought I was done for. Me hut's always open to you.
I'm assuming that you're just based on what I see going around here, going on around here. Yeah, you're an herbalist. Don't mind if I run through your garden quick. I guess we'll have to come back to talk to you, but... Okay, let's actually rest up here. That's not the one we wanted. That's okay, we'll just take both. It's weird, we must have to come back to him. Okay, let's head over to this one. It's close by. Yeah, treasure, but what's... Oh, we've got harpies. Okay, harpies are hybrids. Am I correct? Yep.
What? Lost your nerve?
Come on. I love fighting harpies. There we go.
Time to end this.
Goodbye. You know what's really rare is the red mutagens. It seems like almost impossible to find them. I shouldn't say impossible because that's not true, but... Nicholas Vogel's laboratory notebook, a chest key, some swords, some other stuff. Read the notebook. Okay. First of all, let's get rid of a bunch of stuff we don't need. We don't need any of this. We could sell some, but let's maybe take the weapons and sell those. Fragments of Nicholas Vogel's laboratory notebook. I've acquired the eggs. They cost a fortune and left me with barely enough funds to pay the rent for my laboratory, but now I can begin my work in earnest. I'll soon show those pea-brain admirals of ours that airborne armies are the future of warfare, and the first such army shall be my creation and shall proudly bear the name of the Redanian Air Force. They've hatched, never seen harpies on so tiny, and dare I say, cute. They have no bosoms yet, but they do have enormous heads and equally enormous appetites. Bird-like through and through. My first attempts at taming them have brought promising results. The young harpies eat out of our hands, and sometimes eat our hands as well. My assistant's already lost two fingers. The alderman of Heddle came skittering into our tower, desperately bawling about spiders plaguing in his village, begging for our help, weeping for the picked upon livestock and offspring who suffer the most from the arachnid's bites. One swarm of mindless eating machines preying on another. How dare he interrupt my work on the Wunderwaff for such banalities? Instead of the arachnocide he requested, I gave him a bottle of arachnomorph pheromones. Won't he be in for a surprise? But do the peasants not say spiders and snakes a happy home make? I'm sure I've heard them say something of the sort. Our funds are nearly exhausted. I shall be forced to take something from the rainy day stash I hid from Hubert in the top floor of the tower. The bulk of our outflow goes towards the purchase of pork, which the harpies devour in gargantuan quantities. Perhaps if we were to dress one up in Redanian armor now and present it at court, the king himself would become our patron. No. The entire squadron must be present, else Radovid will deem the whole undertaking a farce. It seems our harpies have grown tired of pork. I found the scraps of Hubert's overalls in one of their cages. No great loss. Hubert had already lost 8 fingers feeding them, couldn't even grip a broom. Catastrophe has struck. Someone opened the cages and let out the harpies. I'm sure I'll find them wheezing their last in the grass outside the tower. After all, no one's fed them for a week. And then he got eaten by his own pets. But we do have some runes here. So his loss is our gain.
Shit.
Look at this. Oh my god. The harpies do all of this? Better be worth it, whatever's up here. Oh. Have the nest. Multiple nests. There it is. New moon trousers, pyrog runestone, diamond dust, and Lesser Dazborg runestone and greater Triglav runestone. We'll take that. Let's check out these pants. They're actually better than what we have. Resistances are pretty good. It's not elemental damage, but hey. Oh, they're a little bit plain. We're just gonna keep what we have. Look at this though. Whoa! This is a great spot. The trick is getting down in one piece. Whoa! Okay, Roach, where to next? Looks like it's a pretty straight beeline into Oxenfurt. We could jump there from Estair. Okay, and into Oxenfurt we go.
Got a monster under my bed. Will you help?
Stay out of my way, crawl back up here.
Now he's gonna be like, thanks, but you gotta get me that house. So your work's not done here, obviously.
Living of God in Imperia can kiss me.
What are they doing?
Playing. Overgrown wains, you see. Have you any children, Geralt?
None.
Oh, yes. Forgot witches is sterile. Well, don't just stare at me. Tell me what brings you.
Well?
Your band. Chosen some interesting specimens.
Interesting? How so? Common carousers and roughnecks, every last one.
Where'd you dig them up?
Some have been with me ages, others are gathered on the road. and a few fell with themselves. They're company for drink and sport, at least. And ever since I began travelling with them, my old enemies have sat quiet as moles.
First time I've seen a saber like that. What's its origin?
Ophir. It was a gift. Any soft-armed craven can hang a blade from his belt, prance about feigning danger. But my saber's a promise. If I reach for it, heads will roll. Mere sight of it quells the urge to duel, in shavers eager to face Olgierd von Everick, the infamous outlaw.
My medallion.
You're pretty humble.
Think it's magic.
It thinks, eh? And I think you've never seen a better weapon.
How can I get my hands on that? That'd be interesting.
Keep wondering how you turned the Ophiri into a beast. More I think about it, more I'm sure it was no run-of-the-mill curse.
This professional curiosity, or nosiness, as common as the clap.
Desire to improve. Information could prove useful down the line.
In the future, you under the delusion you'll complete your tasks, live happily ever after.
Remains to be seen. So for now, admit it. A mage helped you, right?
I'll give you a hint. You're not the only one to fulfill wishes around here.
Oh,
yeah, Master Mirror.
Fury?
Yep.
It was your wish?
Nay. It was my doing alone. But you're right. It was no ordinary curse.
Okay, then.
Though I'll say no more. A curse I uttered in a moment of rage, with no thought to it actually taking hold.
That's bizarre.
Tell me, how'd you meet the Ophiri you turned into a beast?
Aren't you a nosy one?
Yeah.
What's it matter? You like to talk about yourself.
That I cannot deny. Ophiri was a dofer on a voyage through lands unknown to learn of their cultures and customs. He fell for a lass. As it happened, this woman was already important to me. But at the time, I was now compared to a noble from a foreign land. So her parents promised her hand to the Ophiri, though she loved me. If you'd only seen his feeble attempts at charm. When she asked why he traveled disguised as a common merchant, he said he was like the frog from the fairy tale. One kiss from her, and he'd turn into a prince. Wanted to be a frog. Became a frog.
Okay, sketchy. Let's humble him a bit.
You ever play Gwent?
An immortal demands you fulfill three wishes. And you've the gall to propose a
you got it.
Gwent.
Afraid to lose? No problem. I'll find someone else.
Believe that's the worst wind-up I've ever heard. Lay out your cards.
Let's show him who's boss. Monster deck. Not surprised. Okay, decoy, scorch, horn, Taller, medic, death mold. I'd like a few more spies. That I would. Damn it, scorch for scorch. Okay. Let's see. Pretty reliant on spies to do our bidding. There we go. That's what I'm talking about. Now his leader ability here doubles the strength of all spy cards. Okay, that's, I was wondering. Because he comes in as an 8, which is pretty wild. I didn't even notice Taller's, but. Getting decent draws here. I'm hoping he takes that one back too. Nope. I don't think he's got any more decoys. Yikes. Hello. Okay, I don't think I can just let him take this, honestly. We could play these two. That's only two cards that we need to play. and it saves us from a scorch, so let's do it. Oh, interesting. Let's see if he does get another decoy somehow. All right, let's just toss out a little death mold here. He only brought out one group of monsters, so I'm sure there's going to be a ton more flying at us shortly here. Kairin. Okay. I like that. I like that. If he plays something really gnarly here, I might have to back off. Concede. Crone's good option. If I scorch, it's gonna hurt him a hell of a lot more than me. I lose two, he loses four. A toad! Oh, cool! Let's see this. Destroy your enemy's strongest range combat units if the combined strength of all or his or her combat range combat units is 10 or more. That's cool. I hope that's the one we get from him. When we win! I'm just a little bit nervous about him having a scorch. Yennefer, well, that could be trouble. Yep. I think we can handle it. I'll at least hold on to it for the time being. Yeah, there we go. Haven't seen that. Now, if he commander horns that front line, it's gonna hurt. Especially if we put this guy down. Uh-oh. He's got two cards left. Oh, he's done skis. It's cool. I'm gonna embarrass him. Oh, we got the commander's horn, of course. Catapult it is. Danger! There's a close one, Olgierd.
Not much I detest more than losing.
I figured.
Well, my congratulations. This card's yours.
Come on, be the toad.
So long.
I think it was the toad. Yep, beautiful. Okay, tell you what, we're gonna take a break here. When we come back, we'll talk to Olgierd, and then probably try and do the other part of this, which is getting this guy's house. Not sure how that's gonna happen. Probably gonna be difficult. But I'd also like to do this. We talked to the herbalist, and then he lost his apprentice, so we have to go looking for him. And if that's anywhere nearby or in the vicinity of Open Sesame, then we're going to do that as well. All right. We'll see you guys next time. Bye.